Hi, this is Simon with IQRF. In this video, let me show you how to make your upboard Raspberry Pi or any other Linux computer an IQRF gateway and use it for control of any IQRF network. The step-by-step guide is prepared for the upboard, but with minor modifications, you can use the same process for any other Linux computer. First, we install an operating system on the upboard. Then we will install and configure basic services. And last, we will read data and control the development kits that are part of the IoT starter kit. To install Linux, prepare a USB flash drive with a capacity of at least 4 GB, a keyboard, a mouse, a monitor with an HDMI cable, and a connection to the Ethernet network. Read detailed instructions in PDF guide for Part 2 on iqrf.org/IoT starter kit. Download the Ubilinux 4 for upboard and save it on your disk. Then, download the Etcher software for burning an image of the operating system to a USB flash drive and install it. After starting Etcher, select the image of the operating system and choose your USB flash drive to burn it on. After burning the image to the USB flash drive, connect it to the upboard. Your monitor, keyboard, and mouse should be already connected. Connect the IQRF SPI board to the GPIO pins right in the middle of the header of the upboard and turn it on. If you have the operating system installed on your upboard already, press F7 at the beginning and select booting from the USB flash drive. If there's nothing on your upboard, the installation will start automatically. The installation continues automatically and doesn't last for more than 4 minutes. After the operating system is installed, your upboard turns off. Then, remove the USB flash drive, connect the upboard to the Ethernet network, and turn it on again. Log in with the default password Ubilinux. Start your web browser and enter github.com/IQRFSDK. Find the IoT Starter Kit section and installation guidelines. We are now going through the part number 2, installation and configuration of the gateway. At this point, we have already installed the operating system and now we need to get it updated. Copy the command for the update and paste it into the terminal. Enter the default password, Ubilinux. Install the MQTT broker by using this command. Verify that the MQTT broker is running. Now, install the IQRF Gateway Daemon. There are 4 commands that you need to enter into the terminal. The time of the installation mostly depends on the speed of your internet connection. Verify that the IQRF Gateway Daemon is running. Press Q to leave the listing. Now install the web application for the IQRF Gateway Daemon configuration. Copy and paste the commands that are ready for the installation one after the other. Verify that the web application is running by typing a localhost address in your web browser. Log in as admin with the password IQRF. Now configure the connection to the IQRF network through the SPI interface. In the configuration menu, find the IQRF interface item, click on the available SPI interface and save the configuration. Restart the IQRF Gateway Daemon by clicking on Restart in the service menu. You can see here that the daemon has been restarted. Now install the nodejs. This is done by a set of commands that you just copy and paste one by one into the terminal. If necessary, enter Ubilinux as a password. Confirm this query by typing Y as yes. Now install Node-RED. Copy the 2 prepared commands and paste them into the terminal. run Node-RED. Now create a Node-RED dashboard environment. In the browser, enter the localhost address with the port 1880 and select the Manage Palette item from the menu. Find the Node-RED dashboard and install it. Run the prepared example for the IoT starter kit. The acquired data will be visualized in the dashboard and the two relays can be controlled by using these buttons. Use these prepared commands to set up Node-RED to start automatically after switching on the upboard. Verify that Node-RED is running. Check the dashboard at localhost address with the port 1880/UI. If you have your IQRF network with the sensor and relay kit ready, you can see the measured values on the dashboard and switch the relays on and off. At localhost address, port 1880, the Node-RED administration environment can be used to modify your flows and your dashboards. Verify the functionality of controlling the IQRF network from the web application. Use any commands that you know, such as turning on the red LED on the coordinator. You can easily double-check that the command has been executed. In the same way, you can turn the red LED off as well. Check out the DPA commands in JSON format running between Node-RED and the IQRF Gateway Daemon. Insert the command into the terminal to observe the ongoing communication. So, you've just watched how easy it is to make a Linux computer an IQRF gateway and how to control it from a very user-friendly environment. Apparently, you can connect this gateway to any cloud solution, such as Microsoft Azure, IBM Cloud Platform, Amazon Web Services, or anything else. How to do it is the topic of the following videos.